Any questions from the previous class? We discussed about the roles. We discussed about the Ansible vault. Okay. So we'll see some more sample playbooks and also we'll go to roles today. Okay. So let us say I want to create a user. On all agents using Ansible Playbook. So how do we write a playbook to create a user? So what are the things required for a user? So basically he needs a home directory, he needs a password, right? Password, username, group name, and password for user and shell with which he logs into the machine, right? So these are the things, these are some of the things which are required for the user to log in, right? So we basically we want to create a user with a playbook. So let us start creating a user. So if you want more properties for a user, you can just go through the Ansible documentation, right? So there will be some examples. Directly make use of. Okay, so the module is user. We can directly go to the user module and see what all the options available. Okay, so this is to manage the user accounts and user attributes. So there will be a lot of attributes, so we can use whatever is required. So home directory is also required for the user. Shell is required for the user, right? So we can get directly examples like this. Okay, we can just copy them and use them in the, let us say I'll take this. So a little bit modifications we have to do. So we'll try to create a user on the Ansible agent. So I'll just say user.yaml. So I'll just say on which host you want to execute, on web servers, right? And what is the tasks? Create a user on agent. Module name is user, and then we can, what is this thing? We can copy the whatever we have this thing from the documentation, right? So let's delete this. Is this right? Syntax?
I think indentation is enough.
Also, let us say we need to give a password for the user. So how do we give a password? Right? So we cannot give the password directly like something like root 123 ABC 123 in the playbook, right? It has to be encrypted so that nobody should be able to see. So there is a password called OpenSSL hyphen 1 password. There is a command OpenSSL hyphen 1 or something. 1 minute, let me see the syntax. No command. OpenSSL hyphen H. Well, let's see the man page. So we can generate a password, encrypted password using OpenSSL. So I'm just trying to see the examples. Password. So OpenSSL password, so I'll give root 123 and I'll give root 123. What is that? Verifying failed. Root 123. Okay, so when we give that password, it will generate a cryptic password. So this is the encrypted password. So this is the encrypted form of root 123. So this password we can use inside the user, right? So that this password is set as root 123 for the user, right? So for the confidentiality, for the security reason, we can use this password. What is the command? OpenSSL password. To generate a encrypted password for a user. Right, so we can generate a encrypted password for the user. So it will prompt for the password. So we need to enter the password 2 times, and that password will be encrypted, and you'll be given a encrypted string like this. Okay, this we can use inside the playbook. Right, so I have given the password. So for a user, we have name. Let us say I'll give something like user1, and comment. Some comment we give. So this is optional comment. So actually these are the parameters which we create while creating the user, right? We create a user with user add command, right? So in the user add command, we specify all these things. What is the name of the user? What is the shell? Shell also you have to give, right? So shell will give something like bin bash. So when the user logs into the machine, he'll be inside the bin bash. What else? Password we have given. UID is there. Group is there. Comment is there.
Can you add secondary group? Any sample secondary group?
Secondary group. Okay. If I want to add something like that, I need to check if there is any option like that in the entries. Right. Let me see if I have something like that. Group groups puts users in the list of groups. Okay, so I can give groups. Okay, let us see, separated by comma. So groups admin, and we'll give something else also. What is other group? We'll give it to root. Root is also a group, right? So this is what we have. We want to create a user. How do we see users created on a agent? How do I see the existing users on the agent machine?
ID user.
Sorry, I mean all the users created in the Linux machine. I want to list down the users in the Linux machine.
Etc password.
Right. So here it lists all the users which are created, right? So these are the users. So here if you see, user one is not there. So we are trying to create a new user, right? In the same way, if you go to etc groups, so there are all the groups created, right? So there will be somewhere admin. Admin is not there. Admin. Okay, so we have to make sure that the users group is there. This we can use. And what else is there? NTP group user, this we'll use. Okay. So basically we are trying to add a user to these groups. So we have to make sure that the groups are already present, right? So I'll go here and I'll say this admin user group root user is not present. So, or we can create a group as well, right? So let us create a group then. User one, admin. These two groups we'll create on the agent and we'll add the user to those groups. How do we create a use group? Group add admin, group add user one. So we can, you can create any name. So I just created some sample groups. So you can see, sorry, etc password, not etc password, etc group. Here see, you, there are two groups created, admin and user one. What is the GID? Group ID is 1001 and 1002. Okay, so now let us try to execute this playbook and let us see if there are any syntax issues to create a user. So definitely I think there will be some indentation issues. Let us see them. Okay, it is working. Okay, something is changing. Let us see if a user is created. At etc password. See, etc password, there is a user created, user one, with UID we have given 1040, and user is part of user one group, comment is fine, shell is fine, but user is not added to the second group, right? User is added to only one group, user one. We have asked to add it to user admin comma user one, right? So it is not added to admin. Is it added?
I think so. Type ID user one.
What is it?
ID user one, space user one. Yep, it's added, admin and user one.
Ah, okay, yeah, right, so it's added, but it's not showing in etc group, right, so maybe some issue. Ah, okay, it's the admin, user one, user one, user one. Okay, it's added, so it's working fine. So basically we created a user and we added him to two groups, admin and user one. Is this clear? So like this, any playbook, if you need some requirement, we can go to the documentation, search for that particular module and use it. Okay, so any this thing we can go and check in the documentation, right? So another concept is something called handlers. So you remember this OpenSSL password is the command to generate encrypt. Okay, see, by default we create the user, but there has to be home directory created for the user. To create the home directory, we have to give create home is equal to yes, right? So let us see, he's saying create home is equal to yes is by default. Let us see if the user's home directory is created. What is the home directory we have given? Okay, it is created, fine. So in some of the this thing, chef or puppet, we have to specifically mention to create the home directory. So Ansible by default, the home directory will be created. So I did not mention to create the home directory, but it is created by default. Why? Because for create home attribute, the default value is yes. If you don't want to create directory, we have to give create home is equal to no. But for creating by default, it will create a home directory for the user, right? So we can log into the machine using user one. How do we log into the user? Currently, I logged in as root, then su hyphen user one will log me as the user one. What is the ID? User one. What is the groups, users and admin? Present working directory, home user one. What is the shell? It will be bin bash. Is this clear? So I created a user. I logged into the user using user one. And what is the password? By it's set by default. It is root 123. So if you try to log in from other machine, let us try that as well. So I'll try to log into the agent using master. SSH hyphen L user one, this is the IP of the agent, or I can simply type agent. And what is the password? We have given root 123. So I'm able to log into the second machine using user 1 using the password which we have set. Actually, we did not set the password. It is set by the playbook. And did we give the password in the playbook? No, we did not give. We have given the encrypted password, this. And this is equal to root 123. So when you log in, you can just type root 123. This will accept it, because this is the encrypted password which we have encrypted using OpenSSL password command. Is this clear? We created a user, we have set the password, we have added to groups, we have set the bash comment and all, right? So let us see one more thing, handlers, right? So let us say we have written a playbook, so that has install HTTP package, start the service, then copy the template, then copy the file, etc. Right? Now, after copying something, jar file or var file, some application specific data, we need to restart the process. Sometimes too, those changes will be effective only if you restart the process. In those cases, we need to restart the process. But there is a problem. Let us say I have executed a playbook once. Then the process is restarted. There is a change. And I again execute it second time. Right? And there is no change. Simply it is executed. The playbook is executed. So again the process will be restarted, because we have specified to restart the process in the playbook tasks. Right? So playbook is collection of plays. Play is nothing but collection of tasks, right? So there are many tasks, multiple tasks, and one by one it will execute in sequential order from top to bottom. So it should be something like whenever there is change, then only it should restart. Otherwise, it should simply ignore. We don't want to restart the process without any change, right? So developer has modified something and he has pushed. So in continuous integration, let us say everything is happening automatically, right? So we want the process to be restarted only if there is a change in the template, right? Simply we don't want to restart. So for that, we use something called handlers. Right. This handlers will be executed only if there is a change. There is change in content, something like either in index.html or let's say the image file is changed, then only this will be executed. So let us try that. So I'm still in agent, so I'll exit. So now, okay, I logged in as user 1, I am root now, so I am in master now. Now let us write a playbook. I will use the same sample.yaml playbook. So here if you see, the execution order will be top to bottom. So it will install httpd, start the service, it will copy the template, it will copy the image, right? So I'll just create another one otherwise. Copy sample.yaml, so I'll say handlers.yaml. handlers.yaml, just for demonstration purpose, I'll remove this. Now I'll say if template.html modified, then only go for the handlers, right? So I'll just say notify, this is a keyword. Then I'll just say name restart httpd. Now here in handler section, I'll mention hyphen name equal to restart httpd. The same line, basically I need to copy the same lines, two lines. So I'll just say restart service on agent. So this name should be same. So here something like in that above notify keyword, I have given httpd. So I need to give restart httpd the same name. So here service equal to httpd, name equal to, I'll just say restart, state equal to restarted, right? So what is happening here? So when I execute this playbook, the execution happens from top to bottom, install httpd, start the service, copy the template. And if the template is different on the source and destination, then only it will restart httpd. Otherwise it will not change anything, right? So we'll execute this two times and see whether the HTTP is really getting restarted, if there is change.
You give service name restart two places, in the main task section and handler section. Is it okay?
Right, right. So that is because this notify keyword will notify the handler if there is any change. If there is no change, it will not notify, right? So notify will notify restart HTTP. What is restart HTTP? I defined here. So when restart HTTP is called, this task will happen. Clear? Let us see, you will get a more idea when we execute this. So we'll modify something in the index.html. So I'll say, welcome to Ansible 1, something I have given so that there is a change. So Ansible Playbook handlers.yaml. Okay, there is a syntax error. What is that? Line 10. So there is a syntax error in the line 10 and column 7. We'll see that. What is that? Go to directly in the line 10. So notify. Notify is fine. Let me restart HTTP. Check the syntax in documentation. So for anything and everything, we can just check the Ansible documentation. Notify hyphen restart Apache. Okay, name is not required. Let's notify. If restart something in the handlers, name and service. Right. Okay, we'll try this. Executed. So basically I'm asking to copy the index.html from my master to agent. So HTTP is already installed, service is already started, so it will not do anything. Copy the template because there is a change. It is showing in yellow, means that index.html is copied. Then HTTP is restarted. Why? Because there is a change in the index.html on the master and the agent. If you go to agent and access this index.html from web URL, let us see what we'll get. Welcome to Ansible 1, right? This is working fine. So now let us say I'll execute the same thing again. This time, since there is no change, it should not start the handlers, it should not notify, right? So the task of handler should not get executed. See, there are how many tasks executed? 4 tasks executed. Now let me change it again. I'll just say welcome to Ansible 2. Save it and again execute it. Now how many tasks are executed? 5 tasks. So this running handler will be executed only if there is a change in the template, right? Now if I refresh this page, welcome to Ansible 2. So index.html is updated. So if there is any change in the website, let us say, then only that process will be restarted. Let us say in this case, HTTPD, but in reality, if there are some applications running and there is some configuration data, and if there is configuration data changed, then only it will go and update the restart the process, right? So let us say so whatever may be the output, let us say how many number of times you execute the playbook, the output will be same, right? So let us say now we have executed the playbook two times, three times, right? So the output is same, right? So I executed the playbook once. If there is any change, it will modify. If there is no change, it will simply exit without modifying anything, right? So this feature of Ansible is called idempotency. You run the playbook any times, the end result will be same irrespective of the fact that there is a change or not, right? So you execute this playbook 100 times, there is a change, it will modify. If there is no change, it will simply exit without performing anything. So this is called idempotency of Ansible. So the end result will be same whatever the number of times you execute the playbook, right? Something like you multiply a number with 1, right? How many ever times you multiply, the result will be always same. X into 1 is equal to X. That is called idempotency, right? So we'll see something else. What is that? Let us take a scenario in a web servers group. I have 100 machines, right? Now I have written a playbook, playbook.yaml. In the playbook.yaml, I have some something like tasks to be performed, right? So this playbook will be executed on all the 100 machines, right? So this playbook will be executed on 100 machines parallelly. So let us take, I have a task of upgrading my database. So this particular task will be executed from 100 machines 100 times, right? So I have 100 agents and there is one database, which is a centralized database. So I'm running a playbook to upgrade the database. So if I want to update the database, if for the first time when it is executed on the first agent, let us say, it will go and update the database. When it is getting executed on the second agent, then also it will be updated. So this database will be updated 100 times. It's not needed, right? We want to update only once. Since the playbook is getting executed 100 times, so this will be executed 100 times. So I want to restrict this behavior, saying something like, if I execute it from one agent, it should be executed only once, right? So there is a tag called run_once is equal to true. Set this, it will be executed only once. This behavior we can see if we have multiple clients. Right now I think I only have one client. See, I'll just execute and see. Okay. So there is something like, so this way we can, so host is web server, task is create a dummy file, command is touch temp dummy 0, run_once equal to true. If this is executed, let us say in web servers I have 100 machines, this particular file will be created only the first machine, on the first machine, because we have set run_once equal to true. So it will not be executed on all the machines, but it will be executed only on the one machine. Since I have only one machine, I cannot show, but if you have multiple clients, it will work that way. Just a minute. So this would have created a file called temp dummy zero on the agent. Before a few seconds. Yeah. If there is a task which has to be executed multiple times, if a task is getting executed multiple times from different machines in a group, I want to restrict their behavior, and from only the first node this has to be executed. Let us say there is 100 nodes and there are a centralized database and there is a playbook written to update the database from playbook, something like this playbook will be executed on all 100 machines, right? So when we execute a playbook, the host variable is there. So that host is pointing to web server. So web server has 100 machines. So on all 100 machines, it will be executed. But this task, I want to execute only once. Updating the database, I don't want to do it 100 times. I want to do it only one time. So when this is getting executed from the first node, it will be, when I use run underscore once equal to true, it will be executed only once. And when it is getting executed from the all the other nodes, it will ignore. Is this clear?
No. Santosh, executing once means on first node?
Yes, on first node. On first node, it will be executed.
Okay, first node.
Second node, it will not be executed. On third node, it will not be executed. Like that, if there are n number of nodes, it will not execute on all the remaining nodes. Okay? As the name suggests, run underscore once, run only one time.
Is not one time and all nodes?
No, it's run once per playbook. So per playbook, it will be executed only once. Okay, so let us see something else. So we have seen roles yesterday. We have seen three approaches. What is the use of roles? Abstraction. Your playbook will not have anything. Simply, it will have something like -role1, -role2. I can give like this. So in the previous scenario, we have seen there are some common tasks and there are some web server tasks. So how do we define? We define something like common. Then we define, let us say, web server's role or role one, which is actually HTTP installation. So this is executed. Common role will be executed on the group web servers. Role one will be executed on the web servers, right? Then what will be there inside my common? Someone tell me what will be there inside a role. What are the directories we spoke yesterday? From where the execution starts? What are the other directories we have?
Main.
Tasks. Main.yaml. Defaults. Vars. Templates. Files. Okay. So let us try to create one role and understand how this it works. Right. So I'll create a playbook. I'll say role xyz.yaml. Inside the role, I'll simply write associate my host. Web servers. And then in the roles, I'll just say hyphen role 123. Hyphen role, let's say 345, right? So I just created three roles. Some roles I just want to execute on group called web servers. So done. So this is my playbook. Simply it has just the roles information. What is the role we created? Role xyz.yaml. Role xyz.yaml. Now what do we need to create? We need to go to, we need to create directories in etc Ansible roles. Role 123. And role 345. Now, what are the directories I need to create under 123? tasks, vars, defaults, templates, files. Right? Each has a different meaning. In the same way, I'll do this for 3, 4, 5. Role 3, 4, 5 tasks, and then what is that? Templates, defaults, then
files.
Right? Vars. Right. So I mean, it's not mandatory to create all the directories. We can leave some of them empty based on the need. So I'll go to roles 1, 2, 3. Now I have all these directories created. So from where the execution starts, from main.yaml. So let us go to main.yaml and create. So here I can directly write the tasks, because this is a tasks file. I can simply write my tasks here. So what is the task we'll write? Something like install httpd, right? So I'll just say yum package or name. Name is equal to
http.
It's equal to install, right? Sorry, what is it? Start httpd. I'll say service name is equal to httpd. It equal to started, right? So just for dummy role, I'll just have two tasks in the dummy role, right? Let us first see whether this will be executed or not. Then in the same way, I'll go to role 3, 4, 5, right? In the role 3, 4, 5, again, I have directories. In directories, I'll go to tasks, main.yaml. So I'll create a file called main.yaml. Then I'll go to again, I'll directly write the task's name, create a dummy directory on agent. Then what do we give? What is the module to be used to create a directory or file? File. Then file, and what the we'll give the path. Path is equal to temp dummy role 3, 4, 5. Then state is equal to directory. Right? The file module that will create a directory on the agent. The directory name is temp dummy role 1, 3, 4, 5. We'll see if this will work or not. Right. So I have defined two roles, role 3, 4, 5 and role 1, 2, 3. Now let us go to etc Ansible playbooks, and I have role xyz.yaml, which has just two roles. So now if I execute this role on web servers group, it has to install httpd, start the service, and it has to create a dummy file. So let us execute and just see if this really works. Ansible playbook, and then role xyz.yaml. It's getting executed. So I just call the two roles, apply these roles on the group called web servers. So let us install httpd, start is already done, create a dummy directory. Let us see if this really created a directory. Temp dummy role 3, 4, 5. Yes, it is created. Dummy directory created with role 3, 4, 5. So this is a simple example, sample example, just for demonstration purpose. So this can be, this role 1, 2, 3 can be a common role which has lot of tasks like installing SSH, setting the password, creating the users, creating the configuration files, etc., etc. Then this can be your actual role, which is like installing httpd, copying some website data, copying some jar files, copying some var files, restarting the processes, all that stuff. Right? So if this is executed on a set of groups, so web servers will be set up. Let us say next is host is DB servers, role will be common, and next role will be MySQL. So MySQL package will be installed, users will be created, passwords will be set up, configuration data will be done. So all those things will be done using MySQL playbook. Right? So this way roles will be used. Now the next question is how to use the roles. Right? So let us say etc Ansible roles, role 1, 2, 3. In role 1, 2, 3, I have different directories, right? So I'll go to templates. Sorry. Now there is nothing in templates. So let us copy one file from our old index.html. Here I copied index.html and I'll modify something. Welcome to Ansible. I'll just say roles. Right. Now I have index.html in the roles. Now what do I need to modify so that my website will be up with this index.html? Need to modify tasks main.yaml. I have a template now, right? So how do I modify? Simply I'll add name, copy template, then package name, module name is template, sources. So here we can directly give the index.html and destination is equal to var www.html index.html, right? And we can also, if you want, give the notify keyword to restart notify. And what is that? Restart GPD, right? Then I can give handlers. Yeah, handlers also I can specify in a different directory. So that also we'll try, right? So roles, make dir handlers. In handlers again main.yaml, so I had to go to handlers in main. So basically here you are dividing, you are segregating everything, right? So I'll just say handlers and then I'll give what is that name of the handler, name is start httpd service module name is equal to httpd, state equal to restarted. Is this okay? Are you following? See, we have a role. In the role, in previously we have defined everything inside one playbook. Now everything is segregated. There is a directory for template, there is a directory for files, defaults, vars, handlers. Handlers also we have a file. Right? We have a file for handlers. There we specified what need to be done if we have restart Apache HTTPD. Handler is specified in the playbook, right? I think this is also not required. It's already in the handlers file, right? So let us try this. And so let me go to etc Ansible roles playbook and execute Ansible playbook role xyz.yaml.
Yes, Santosh, when you execute the roles, it's gonna execute like what sequence? It's gonna execute first the main.yaml under vars or like yes. what is the sequence? No,
I'll come to that. So what happened now? We have defined a role. Inside the role we have many directories. I have specified handlers in a different directory. I have specified templates in a different directory. In the templates I did not give full path, I just said index.html. How did role automatically pick up? Because it knows that it is executing role 123 and it went inside the templates from role 123 and executed. If you see, template is copied, handlers also called. So what is the flow here? Flow is first always under under tasks main.yaml will be executed. So based on the main.yaml, the next execution flow goes. If main.yaml calls another script using include, it will call that script. Or if it uses a variable, it will go to vars directory. Or it uses any templates, it go to templates directory. If it uses some handlers, it will go to handlers directory. But always the execution starts from tasks main.yaml. Is this clear?
Okay, so whatever is mentioned in the main.yaml is going to execute. Yes. You can look at any of the directories or templates, anything mentioned in the main, right?
Yeah, anything given in roles, it will automatically execute that from tasks main.yaml. So the flow will be like this. It will install HTTP first, it will start the service, it will copy the template. So to copy the template, where does it go? It goes to template directory. If you see source, I have just given index.html. I have not given path, but it automatically knows that it has to pick from role 1, 2, 3 templates directory. Same way file. If file is there, it will pick from that path. And notify restart stdpd. I just say restart stdpd. I did not give handlers in this playbook. Then it goes to next directory, which is handlers. And from handlers, there is main.yaml. So it will go and execute this particular thing. So basically, this is like we are following the best practices in programming. We have segregated our program to different directories, and it looks a lot clearer, right? You have everything properly aligned. You have a proper directory structure. And then let us see, I want to print something on my website, right? So etc Ansible playbooks. Inside the role, I have templates. Index.html is there. Now, instead of welcome to Ansible, I'll just print something else, right? So how do I print? Let us say I just copied something, and now I'll say variable I want to print HTTP port is. So I'll just say HTTP underscore port. So this is a variable I want to use, and I want to display something on my website, right? So where do I define my variable value? So I'll go to defaults. In defaults, I'll define again main.yaml. In main.yaml, I simply say HTTP underscore port is equal to, let us say 111, right? So I just defined a variable inside my template. When template is copied to the node, it gets copied, right? So that value has to be populated from somewhere. So where does it populate? That we'll see. Initially, I added defaults directory, right? So let us see what happens. On the website, I modified something, and I modified defaults main.yaml. Let us see if actually displays port or not. So Ansible playbook and role xyz.yaml. Is that error defaults main.yaml? File for role 1, 2, 3 must contain a dictionary of variables. Etc Ansible roles role 1, 2, 3 defaults main.yaml. Something wrong with the declaration. Okay, did I declare something wrong? 1 minute, let me see.
So if task main.yaml is not present, it will go and look for the default main.yaml, right?
No. It will not look. Let 1 minute. I'll come to that. I think I have in my application somewhere. Syntax. Okay, it should be colon. The mistake we have done is it should be a colon, not equal to. So let us try this again. We come to your question. Getting executed. Let us complete this end. Okay, something is modified on the template. So let us go to this and refresh. And what is it? So HTTP port is 111, four ones. From where it is copied actually? If you go to etc Ansible roles and role XYZ. So role 123. In 123, in templates, I just specified HTTP port is HTTP underscore port. It picked up this file. It is showing it on the website, and but this variable is replaced, populated with 111. From where it is populated? From default directory. In default directory, I specified HTTP port is equal to 111. So from there, it picked up and it populated the variable. So this defaults directory, vars directory are just for specifying the variables, right? Tasks is the one where actually all the tasks will be present. The execution starts from tasks main.yaml and it follows the flow of the playbook, whatever is there in the tasks main.yaml, right? Now, let us do one thing. Let us also create a file in main.yaml, and in main.yaml, I'll just say HTTP underscore port is equal to 222. So now the same variable is defined two times. One is on the var directory, one is on the default directory. Now if I execute the playbook, this thing from where it will pick up, either from defaults or from var directory. So when we write a playbook, we segregate it into different directories. Main tasks directory will have the all the tasks to be performed. Handlers will have handlers to be notified and restarted. And your vars will have variables. Defaults also will have variables, right? Templates will have templates, and copy files will have the files. Now I have defined the variable in two places. One is vars directory, the other is the defaults directory. So where it will pick up? Where it will be populated from? Is it vars or defaults? Right. If I refresh, this will be 111 or it will be 222. We'll see. So it actually overwritten, right? Right. So we have vars also, it's declared. We have also defaults declared, but vars has the highest precedence compared to defaults. So that's why default value is overridden and vars value is specified. Is this clear? The same variable is declared two times, one inside vars, one inside defaults. So if nothing is declared in vars directory, it will take from defaults. If something is already declared in vars, it will override and it will take from the vars directory. Is this clear? Is this clear? So now we'll also do one thing. We'll also define in playbook itself. So let us see from where it will pick up. So what I'll do is I'll just say roles is equal to role 123 and I'll specify underscore port is equal to 333. Inputs in brackets. So it's now it's defined in var directory, it is defined in default directory, it is also defined in roles directory. So let us say from where it will pick up. Playbook role xyz.yaml. Okay, there is a syntax issue. Let's try to fix it. Roles, I think there is some syntax we need to follow. 1 minute. be specified this way. Also equal to role XYZ. I'll also specify HTTP underscore port is equal to 333. Now it is defined three ways. One is VAS directory, one is default directory, the other is a playbook. Now let us execute and see where it will. Role XYZ or not, sorry, role XYZ or role.
I think it's role 1 to 3.
Okay, role 1 to 3, yeah, right. Okay, so something is copied. So let us go and refresh whether it will show 111 or 222 or 333. So if you see, it is showing 333. So this is the variable precedence. So if a variable is defined in defaults, sorry, it is defined in VARs, and if it is defined in playbook. So if it is defined in playbook, this has the highest precedence. So this will get the, this will be populated. Then if it is not defined, then it will go to VARs. This has second precedence. And if it is declared in default, this has the last precedence. This is called variable precedence. Is this clear? So like this, we can declare the variables. Let us say, I want to define something like this. Bill roles, role 1, 2, 3, and then templates and index.html. So I just want to specify my Ansible underscore OS underscore family. Right? So how do we specify that? Let us, so I'll just say my OS family is, my OS is, so I'll just say Ansible underscore OS underscore family, right? So let us see what it will display if I execute this playbook. Something has changed. Let us go to this and see what is it displaying. My OS is Red Hat. So from where this variable is populated, what is that called? From where this variable is populated. This variable, my OS is, it is replaced with Ansible underscore OS underscore family. From where it is coming, from where it is picking, anyone? No, task doesn't have anything. We did not define anywhere this variable. On the flight is taking. What is
it's
the
from component? The facts. It's yeah. The facts. It's
yeah, so the component which stores the values of all the agents is facts. So you can use any variable from the facts to display like this, right? So to display like this, you can use any variable, IP address, what else, the RAM or the CPU or the file system, mount point, the hardware architecture, anything you can display on it, any variable you can use inside the playbook. Okay, so we'll stop here. We'll see some more roles tomorrow, and most probably tomorrow we'll complete Ansible, and then we'll start with something else. Okay, so thank you. We'll stop here. Okay.